Here we go. Today, we'll get to the Arctic Ocean and hopefully we'll be able to camp there if the weather allows us, because every day is different. Might be like super cold and windy, or it could be a beautiful day. So, we'll see. And we are getting closer to the ferry. I believe there are only two ferries on this route. So this is our second one. Yesterday we did the first one. Ooh, this is a long way. So that's the ferry. Weird. It's coming from that way. Okay, it's our turn. That's it. I think this is our last ferry for today. Look at this. I can't believe this. Just before Inuvik, we have a paved road. I had no idea, but that's probably because of mining and operations here and all sorts of stuff. So probably, what, we've got 11 kilometers to Inuvik, and that will be all paved. Ah, what a strange feeling to be riding on asphalt. And we are officially in Inuvik. This is a very large city. I had no idea. Proper roads, paved roads, hotels, like, wow. It must be, most of the people, I reckon, they fly in, fly out. So see, like, this is the architecture. This is how they build houses here. Everyone's entrance, you have stairs to get up, of course, because of the snow. So all the buildings are elevated. And there's no basement. Yeah. I got the fuel, I had some lunch in town. Now it's time to go to Tuktoyaktuk, which is our final destination. Tuktoyaktuk is 150 kilometers away. Where did you go? And hopefully, if the weather is like this, we'll be able to camp at the Arctic Ocean. You probably can't see it on the camera because the road looks smooth. But this is just this type of road. It's got a lot of this like loose gravel on the top. So you're sort of like wobbling along. So I'm just like standing up, leaning down, leaning back. And apparently this road condition we're gonna have all the way to Tak. This road just hasn't been done properly. They just throw gravel on top without compacting it properly. So it's gravel. It's just like this rocks. When you look at the map, it's just like water. I don't know. It looks like ponds, but it's not ponds. I think maybe this water is connected. I'm not sure. But yeah, this is pretty much this part of Canada. No trees. Just grass and a lot of water around. We have made it! Woohoo, Chile! We made it. This is our last stop on our journey north. After that is just Arctic Ocean.
I feel fulfilled. We made it to the tip of the continent. Right, so this is official Tuktoyaktuk sign. The town is just there. We're gonna drive in to see how people live in these harsh conditions all year round. Yeah, imagine, it's just like pitch dark winter. Like, just sun doesn't go down. I mean, doesn't come up. And this time of the year, this is pretty much where the sun is. It just goes like around the horizon. It just, yeah, that's it. It just doesn't go down. Yeah, we'll be camping somewhere. We have to figure out where.
We're getting closer. So I didn't do any research in terms of Tuktoyaktuk. I just wanted to arrive here like with a clear mind. You know, how the community on the top of the world looks like. And I was imagining there will be some trees. Just checking the temperature. The temperature is now 8 degrees. 8 degrees. Well, it's not that bad, actually. It's a warm 8 degrees. I just can't stop thinking, you know, how life looks like. That's a souvenir shop. Maybe tomorrow Chile will stop because it's probably late, it's closed. Yeah, I just can't stop wonder how our general store is here. Okay, I just can't stop wonder how the life looks like here winter time. When it's just pitch dark for a long time and cold. How you motivate yourself to do anything? I couldn't live. Honestly, I need the sun because otherwise I just get really sad. So I couldn't live in a place like this, but it's just, I just can't stop wondering. It must be so tough. 8 degrees, Lokara, and short sleeve, of course. This is the summer. There's lots going on here. It's bigger than I thought it is. So now we're going to the end of the road. Literally, this is the name of the road. And I'm pretty sure camping here, it's 60 bucks. Yeah, like this. Canada Trans Trail. Yeah, I've been told camping here it's $60, but maybe we'll be Arctic Ocean. This is our sign, Chile. This is it. Mm-hmm. We're doing it. Let's go from this side.
The sign, I got to dance, I got to meet the locals, he was super awesome. So yes, I'm a bit emotional. Officially, we are at the Arctic Ocean. What a great feeling. Unbelievable. We made it, Chile. Bloody Arctic Ocean, hey? We'll be right back. hello again.
Hi.
Hi again. So we'll be neighbors again at this epic location. So I don't know, I think all the spots are taken, right? But anyway, we're saving a lot of money. Instead of me paying $60, you guys pick $60. We're just gonna 3-4 after there. We're gonna take one campsite for $60, 20 each. Yeah. It's a bargain, I reckon. Yeah, absolutely. So yeah. It's a very important moment on our journey, right?
Indeed.
It's the yes. most northern part we will ever be.
Yeah.
In Northern America.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
No further than this.
No.
No. It's the end of the road.
That's it. Okay. So,
when you are alone.
As we were sitting down, new people have arrived to our campground, and these guys are from Poland. Guys, you are traveling from Mexico across the states, and then Alaska, Canada, and then who knows?
Later. Who knows?
Yes, who knows?
Who knows? How long have you been on the road?
A few months. Now.
8 years.
8 years.
Ago. It depends because it was only short break in Poland. Two years.
Yes. Exactly.
For COVID.
Yes.
For COVID. Yes.
Yeah. For COVID. Spent few.
Well, so yeah, so we are all sharing the same campground. So turn out this campground didn't turn out so expensive. We have to do this. We're going all the way there to do this.
It's so cold.
Now we are a rock band. Yes, totally. We all are a rock band now. So our plan is not to swim because we are just too sensitive enough and it feels like it's really freezing, so we're just not brave enough, but that's okay. Our plan is to dip our feet in the ocean. You ready?
Yeah! Absolutely! Best place on earth, yeah!
You look awesome. Thank you so much for your help with taking pictures of me.